In this module, we'll look at the form I-983. Today, we'll learn what the form I-983 is and how to complete it. Form I-983 is a formal training plan between you and your employer. This will list employer and employee information. The plan will describe how the practical training is related to your STEM degree, training goals and how they're achieved, and finally, the methods of oversight and supervision of the STEM OPT student. Let's go through the form I-983 together. This is the first page of the I-983 form. The name of the school recommending STEM OPT is the University of Washington. The STEVIS school code is on page 1 on the I-20 with STEM eligible degree. Next, the DSO name and contact information should be a current DSO at the University of Washington. The STEM OPT requested period will begin the day after your post-completion OPT ends. Next, the qualifying major and zip code can be found on page 1 on your I-20. Next, the question, based on prior degree, refers to whether you're applying for STEM OPT extension based on your recently earned degree at the University of Washington. Most students would answer no to this question because they're applying based on their most recently earned degree at UW. But if you're applying for STEM OPT extension based on a previously earned degree at UW or at another US institution, you should answer yes. Lastly, your employment authorization number is a USCIS number found on your OPT EAD. Section 2 is the bottom half of page 1 of the I-983 form and needs to be signed by hand. Now let's review page 2, section 3, where you'll list your employer's information. You should list your employer's name as found in the E-Verify system. Next, the employer ID number, or EIN, is a 9-digit number. This is different from the company's E-Verify number. Next, the bottom half of page 2 will be signed by your employer by hand. Page 3, section 5 begins the training plan between you and your employer. You will need to list the name of the site where you will work. This can be the same as your employer's name. Enter the exact address where you will work. Next, your supervisor or HR coordinator can provide this information. The rest of page 3 is filled out between you and your employer and will outline your training goals and supervision. Page 4, section 6 will need to be signed by your employer official by hand.